First responders are learning about and training on the new stretch of 540 that doesn't open for a couple of weeks.
13 different agencies got together. They're going through a mock emergency so they can familiarize themselves with the area before you start driving on it. WRO's Brett Neese is live at that training site in Apex. Brett, emergency crews can't train like this very often. It's pretty realistic.
Exactly, Jeff, and it's so rare that they're able to train on an actual road before it even opens. It's not often that they get to do that. That's why it's so invaluable, today's training. Crews have now left the scene. They are debriefing how today went. So I want to show you the scenario that they went through. Take a look at this. You can see that there is an overturned box truck that is carrying hazardous materials. It overturned onto that car and trapped a driver inside. Crews responded in real time to this scenario. They assessed the situation, and they even called for UNC AirCare to fly a patient to the hospital. This is as close to a real-life scenario as they can get.
As close as you can get, and so when it really does happen, you got a plan and you know what to do, and you're not fumbling and stumbling through it.
Firefighters say cross-training like this allows them to learn how different departments handle things. As far as when phase one of Complete 540 will reopen, Tropical Storm Debbie pushed it back to a reopening or to an opening date, a grand opening date, to after Labor Day. That's so construction crews can get back out here and complete all the work that they have to do before you get to drive on it. Live in Apex, Brett Neese, WRL News.